it's great to have you with us for this Women's Asian Cup quarterfinal between Chinese Taipei and the Philippines from the Sri Shiv Chhatrapati Sports Complex in Pune. Kickoff is 19:30 local time. It's a couple of degrees cooler than it was this afternoon, with the merest hint of a breeze. Chinese Taipei are making their 14th appearance at the finals. They've been champions three times, the last when they beat India in India in 1981, all of 41 years ago. They were the first team to arrive at this tournament. They won their two qualifying games and came into the competition on the back of two consecutive victories without conceding. But they were given a rude awakening by their old rivals, China, who unpicked their defence early in the opening game. They went on to lose 4-0. Their second game against India, you may remember, was called off because of a COVID outbreak. But they sealed their place in the last eight by beating Iran 5-0. Philippines reached this competition by winning both qualifying games in Tashkent in September. In the group stages, they began with a 1-0 win over Thailand, then suffered a heavy defeat against Australia before clinching a quarter-final berth with a 6-0 win over Indonesia. This is their 10th appearance at the Women's Asian Cup. In the last edition in Jordan in 2018, they finished 6th. The two sides have met twice before in this tournament. Chinese Taipei have won them both 12-0 in 1993 and 4-0 more recently in 2003. Chinese Taipei will play in blue with Philippines in white. Not just a place in the semi-finals of this competition at stake. The winners will reach the World Cup finals in Australia and New Zealand next year. Sadly, no fans in the stadium, as there hasn't been for any game at this tournament. Played behind closed doors because of COVID restrictions. And a reminder that there will be extra time and penalties in this quarterfinal if required. Korea Republic await the winners. That match to be played on Thursday.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand up for the anthem of Chinese Taipei. national anthem of Philippines.
One change for Chinese Taipei. It's a big one too. Lai Li Chin, who scored a hat-trick against Iran, will take no part in the game. Wong comes into midfield and will lead the side. This is how we anticipate they'll line up. Three at the back with a single striker up top. Five substitutes are allowed, with one extra permitted in extra time if we get there. Number 17, Tong Chi, is a goal threat from the bench. Referee. The aim. I from Myanmar. She's been on the international list since 2016. Captain for Chinese Taipei and Long for the Philippines. That's the VAR crew. Goals, penalties, straight red cards and cases of mistaken identity will be reviewed. Now the Philippines line up. Three alterations for them as the coach, Alan Stadic, shuffles his pack. Long and Harrison return to the defence and Quezada comes into midfield. The Philippines will play with two up front. It's a bold team selection. Among the replacements, Sarah Castaneda has 10 international goals in her 43 appearances. The Chinese Taipei skipper, one of the older members of the side at 34. For Philippines, there are two sisters in the lineup. Olivia McDaniel is in goal, and Chandler McDaniel plays up front. Olivia is the older of the two. Coach said they weren't so much nervous as really excited for this one. Chinese Taipei start favourites. And we are underway in Pune. Ranked 13th in Asia. Chinese Taipei 8. The world ranking for the Philippines is set at 64. They have never been higher. So this is the best side that they've ever had. And they are in the quarterfinals of the Women's Asian Cup and bidding for a place in the final four. This is Wong for Chinese Taipei. Harrison got a foot on it. Lee. Foul. Very influential player for Chinese Taipei. Li Suqin. Good technique. Likes to play wide right. She wins the header and stops the ball from going out of play. Lost their first game to China quite heavily, but they were undone by conceding two very early goals. And they had no real chance of coming back, and then that game against India didn't take place. But they beat Iran comfortably. And here they are, bidding for a place in the semi-finals, bidding for a place in the World Cup finals. Nobody near. Down the line it goes. The early cross is partially blocked and Chinese Taipei can come away with it. Lee, errant ball, intercepted by Bugai. Randall, misplaced. Of Japan, 56 years old, took over in 2019. First touch of the ball for Olivia McDaniel. She's going to go long. Lee lets it bounce over her head and Chinese Taipei can build from midfield, but a miscommunication. Wei Hsu asking why the ball wasn't played to feet. Madarang. They've lost it. And now here's Su. Faced by Long. Surrounded by white shirts. Chandler McDaniel. The 11 of the Philippine squad are at college in America. Okay, flicked forward by Chandler McDaniel, and Pan had to come across. Nervy opening from both sides. There's a lot at stake. Oh, and Chinese Taipei have taken advantage of her hesitation. This is Chen. Support on this near side from Pan. No way through for Chen. Chinese Taipei have it back. Just seeing a little bit more of the ball than Philippines. Gilu, too strong, but it will come for Kazara. Still there for Philippines. Zhou puts her foot through it to clear the danger. So neither side has settled as yet. Alan Stadich, an Australian, appointed in October last year to oversee the Philippines campaign in this tournament. Madurang. That's my suit. Another throw. Chinese Taipei on the back foot. And Madurang will wind up another long one. It's a potent weapon. A disappointing end to what could have been a promising situation. The long throw is going to cause Chinese Taipei problems. And perhaps just a little bit more patience required, especially early in the game. Earlier on, we saw Australia panic a little bit against Korea after missing a number of chances. So under this kind of pressure, cool heads are needed. Long tidies up. Madurang forward. It will get through. Pan across, comes out to Chen, the first time pass, is intercepted by Miklat. Shoot. YH shoot, couldn't quite collect that one. Chinese Taipei trying to zip it around, move the ball quickly. Pan steps in, plants it forward. Covering is long for Philippines. And she has plenty of time. Oh, mistake. Randall was covering. And perhaps the Philippines can build something down their left-hand side. Oh, that's a good pass, and they're in behind them here. Promising for the Philippines. Still going into the side netting. Best moment of the game so far. Bolden acknowledges the pass. She outpaced Light. Goalkeeper got her angles right. Taken quickly and short. Randall. It's a good ball back in. And the goalkeeper comes to collect. Good couple of minutes. For Serena Bolden. One of two players playing further up the field. For Philippines this evening. There she is again, winning a free kick. Looking lively. Miklat with it. And again, just a rush of blood, this time from Madarang. Ball is headed clear, and that's recycling it and having another go. Would have been a better option. Xu wins the header. Zhou wants to take the throw in quickly, and she does. Chinese Taipei making ground down their right hand side. Philippines working hard to deny them space and time. Chong. We had a long look at that. Into the throat for Wei Xu, and now the referee will stop it and just go and make sure that she's okay. Difficult to see from that angle exactly what happened. Wei Xu obviously felt something. Drop ball. And we're underway again. Randall finds Miklat. Quezada takes over. Miklat has it back. Madarang. Gilu helps it out. Miklat once more. Nice first touch. Madarang takes over. This is better from the Philippines. Starting to apply some pressure. Xu does well. Gilu challenging. Forces a throw-in, good play. From Katrina Gilu, who plays her football in Sweden. Harrison with the throw. Lee heads it on. Wei Xu, who's recovered from that blow to the throat. Miscue. Pan felt that. That will be a free kick. Wong back inside. A little bit aimless, that free kick. Lacking a little bit of precision so far, Chinese Taipei. Bolden chased. Wong. Chen. Forced back. Chung goes square. Xu has to turn back as well. Philippines defending really well. They're really well organized. Gilu wins the throw in. given away. Chinese Taipei had plenty of blue shirts forward, but couldn't find one of them. Harrison plays it out. Good interception from Pan. And they're in! And the first shot of the game is comfortably held by Olivia McDaniel. YH Su. With the first effort on target. Good interception, good reading of the game from Pan. Moved swiftly to Su. Oh, lovely take from Chandler McDaniel. Bugai. Su away. Harrison. Good pressure from Philippines. Win the ball back. Long leaves it. Posada involved. Bugai spreads it wide. Bolden makes the run, but has to check as Chinese Taipei hold their line. Snapshot is well wide from McDaniel. It's a poor clearance. Just the one shot on target from that lady there. Quezada wins the header. Certainly feels like Philippines have been on top in the first 18 and a half minutes of this game. Madarang almost leaves it behind her, draws the foul. Just knocked off balance. Three blue shirts around her. Opportunity to put it towards the edge of the penalty area for the Philippines. Gilu and Quezada together. Bolden in there as well. And one in the air. Cleared away at the second attempt by Chinese Taipei. Miklat. The guy was under pressure. Chinese Taipei not happy with that decision. Thought they had the blue guy there. It's a little bit of a hospital pass and she had blue shirts swarming around her. The referee came to the rescue of Philippines. Only partially cleared. Madarang plays a 1-2, just upping the tempo. Here's Bolden, really good cross. Too deep for Quezada. Bolden making the run, staying onside. Keeper away. But not very far. Chinese Taipei can have a little bit of time on the ball, which they haven't done so far, and they've wasted that. Just being a little bit rushed. Philippines working hard to stifle the opposition in midfield, and so far they're on top in that area of the pitch. Miklat steps inside the challenge. Oh, and the ball falls kindly for Quezada, and the cross is dealt with in the end, and it comes off Chen. Philippines upping the tempo. Helped on by Bugay, Harrison. Shot is easily snaffled by the goalkeeper. But once again, good pressure from Philippines. This is a good contest, this. Pretty even so far, with Philippines on top in terms of possession and territory. Chinese Taipei dangerous on the counter-attack. Now Joe can perhaps launch another one. Crossfield pass. Oh, might come for Chen! McDaniel down to save. It's the Philippines goalkeeper who's had to make two saves so far. Two opportunities to clear it. Bolden helps it on. Bugay, nice and tidy. Quezada, neither one thing nor the other. Chinese Thai player down, injured. It's Chen. Got a swinging boot to the midriff, completely accidental. It was the follow through of a shot. Chung Soo Yu, the Chinese Taipei goalkeeper, plays her football in Japan. Be seriously tested in this game. Harrison concedes a throw-in. Sue. Randall lets it bounce, then has time to clear. Chandler McDaniel was looking for Bolden with the flick. Free kick, Philippines. Much further back than that. Well read by Sue. McDaniel picks up the loose ball. Couldn't get her foot round the cross. Chen is brought to the ground by Miklat. Maybe Chinese Taipei were fortunate to get that decision, because it certainly seemed like Miklat had stopped the ball and then Chen fell over her own feet. Goalkeeper's ball. YH Su has looked lively, the number 19. That's her namesake, S.Y. Su. Plowing a lone furrow up front, but she has caused problems. Chung's header is a good one. Haven't seen much of Lee on that far side. Hasn't really been able to get in the game. And he's bundled over. And here's McDaniel. That's a clever ball. Bolden. And still Bolden! Needed saving. Good effort. Picking up the ball, taking on Lai, and the goalkeeper had to keep that out. Probably wouldn't have gone in had the goalkeeper not got a hand to it. Serena Bolden looking lively. Goalkeeper comes and makes a really good grab under pressure. That's a safe pair of hands. Long, the Philippines captain feels the force. Really good goalkeeping, and to hang on to it and under that kind of pressure and a teammate in the way as well is pretty good going from the goalkeeper. Long, I fancy, is winded. Sure he'd be entirely happy with what he's seen. I think he'll be the happier of the two coaches, Alan Stadich of Philippines. Nearly half an hour played. Philippines have had most of the ball. Chinese Taipei probably created the two best openings. It's pretty even in this quarter-final. Even though it's coming to up to 8 o'clock local time, it's still very warm. It was a hot one this afternoon when Australia and Korea Republic played. Temperatures around about 32 degrees at game time. Not so warm this evening, around about 26, but players feeling it, and the goalkeeper has injured herself. I wonder if that's a shoulder she may have banged when falling to the ground. It was an awkward fall. Long is back on her feet. She's got her wind back. What's the signal to the bench? That means okay. Just checking that the goalkeeper does indeed need treatment. So I think it was shoulder, now it's ankle. She does well to get the cap off the bottle with goalkeeping gloves on. Simon Young, warming up, approaching 20 caps, so no novice if she was required between the sticks, but looks like Chung's going to be okay. Kazuha doesn't have to use one of his substitutes just yet. And it looks like we are ready to continue. Wong. That stoppage just broken up a little bit of the rhythm that the game had. And probably works in favour of Chinese Taipei because it was the Philippines who were making the running. Jump forward. Chen helping it on. Shoot. Chen won't get there. Long back defending. She's recovered. McDaniel hustled out of it. Philippine throw. That halter position. And here she is in possession. Chen to her. And the blue wave was coming. And pressured Philippines into making an error. And Lee, not for the first time, goes to ground a little bit too easily. Philippines ball. She looks at the referee, but it's just a nudge. Over the head of Bolden. Oh, goalkeeper Smith kicked it. Oh dear, oh dear. Oh, that could have been embarrassing. Beaten by the bounce. Sue with the back pass and corner. Oh, Chinese Taipei won't want this one to go in. Cleared away as far as Harrison. Stepping across is Chung. So Sue with the back part. Let's not be too harsh on the goalkeeper because it was an awkward pass and perhaps instead of trying to clear it, may have tried to control it, but Bolden was putting her under pressure. The goalkeepers union sticking together. Oh, so VAR used for the first time. Check is over. Harrison's little fake took out two players, but not the third. Asks for it and gets it, helps it on. The white shirts have it back again. To the last 10 minutes of the first half. It's been cagey. Interesting rather than exciting. one or two moments to get the pulse racing, but sides cancelling each other out. Philippines definitely on top for long periods, but Chinese Taipei looking dangerous. It's a clash of styles. Clear-cut chances few and far between. Bolden. First time cross, reaches its target. Very, very difficult ball to get on target and keep down. Zada read where it was going to go. It's Bolden again causing problems for Chinese Taipei. And playing with a smile on her face. Chung takes her time. Looks to have fully recovered. Philippines will come again. Quezada once more. Supporting is Madurang. The first time ball is in to the area, and McDaniel ambitious from there. Stepped in, but ball falls to Chinese Taipei. Randall has to cover. Good pass from Olivia McDaniel. Down the line it goes. Collected by Chandler McDaniel. Target was Bolden. Once again, the goalkeeper in no hurry to put this ball in play. And at last, Lee does get a free kick. The third time of asking. Will send it into the area. Chung up from the back. So too soon. Towards the central defenders it goes. Quite had the pace to get round Madurang. Lee had taken up a good position and wins a corner. Opportunity for Chinese Taipei. Xu will take it. Shout of no fouls. Good movement from Chinese Taipei. They win the ball in the air as well, but it wasn't going to threaten the goal. And Olivia McDaniel had time to gather it quite comfortably. That's Mai Su with the header. Off the head of Chung, his expression very serious. This is all business and it's very tense. Very tight. As we await the first breakthrough. And this is the last of the quarterfinals. China, Korea and Japan already through. The winners of this one will meet Korea in Pune on Thursday. Bolden. Gilu makes the run. Sends in a really good cross. Perhaps Madarang will get there and keep it in play. She does. And that's a really good cross as well, and Bolden was first to it. Not a clean contact. More good play from the Philippines, though. Madarang chased it down, immediately looking to send in an early cross. And perhaps Bolden took her eye off it for a fraction of a second. Couple of minutes to half time. Madarang, a willing runner to support the midfield and the front players. Slight miscontrol by Bolden, but Philippines get away with it. They lose the ball though, it's with Wong. That was a little bit careless, so Bolden can step in. And here's Harrison. Gilu trying to make herself available. Wins the ball, does really well. Bolt, though. Back she goes to Harrison. No space over on the left-hand side. Sophia Harrison. Bugai. Harrison. Now she does send the cross in. Philippines will be happy with their first half performance. They will feel that perhaps they deserved a goal for some of their play and some of the territory and possession they've had, but aside from one or two moments, they haven't really put Chung in the Chinese Taipei goal under pressure. And they have been susceptible to the counter, although it was earlier in the game and Daniel had to make a couple of saves, but nothing too alarming. So perhaps a little bit of disappointment on the Chinese Taipei side. 2 minutes of stoppage time at the end of this first half. Bolden wins the throw. She's going to leave it to Madarang. She's caught the eye. And Serena Bolden. Goalkeeper's ball. Can come again. Bolden coming out wide. Not for the first time, Quezada has a go from distance, but it's hugely ambitious. First time effort, hoping to catch the goalkeeper out. She's had a couple of opportunities, Sue, the lone striker for Chinese Taipei, but hasn't had much support and hasn't had much service. Peddling his pan. Chen keeps it in play, but not before the half-time whistle goes. Goalless here in Pune. And Serena Bolden has been the pick of the players for the Philippines. She's worked tirelessly up front, and there have been one or two chances created. Perhaps the best falling for Chinese Taipei and their front runner, Wei H. Su. She's had a couple of goes on goal. But if I'm entirely honest, it's been a little bit disappointing. Philippines in the ascendancy haven't been able to turn that into goals. Chinese Taipei not quite playing at the level they did in their last group game. More to come from them. And cross fingers for the second half. But at halftime, it's Chinese Taipei 0, Philippines 0. Welcome back to the second half of this Women's Asian Cup quarterfinal between Chinese Taipei and Philippines. 0-0 at half-time. Philippines with more of the ball, more of the territory, but unable to convert that superiority into goals and into chances. Chinese Taipei forced into playing on the break. They were on the back foot for most of the game. But both goalkeepers have only seen occasional action. And it was a half of very few clear-cut chances. I suspect the Philippines' game plan is more of the same in the second half. Chinese Taipei were the disappointing side. Not quite at the level that is required and that they showed against Iran in their final group game. But it is a very even contest. And you couldn't pick a winner. Funnily enough, like the first game in Pune this afternoon, where it was really tight until very late on, and then a wonder goal from G, sending Korea into the semi-finals and into the World Cup finals. Team in Australia out of the competition. Very pink socks for Olivia McDaniel. Bolden loses out. The attempted clearance is sliced. Harrison goes down the line looking for Bolden, who was the liveliest of the Philippines players. Gilu. Harrison steps in. Bolden is thwarted. Harrison again, good control from her. Has to go back though. Bugai. Harrison down the line, that's a good ball. Oh, Bolden just hesitated. I don't know if she thought that she could reach it. The impression was that she could if she'd have kept going. And it allowed Joe to step in and at least clear it away for a throw-in. Have the range with her throw, but it's still a good one into the area. Chinese Taipei deal with it effectively. And Randall says, I'll look after that. And we'll start again. Philippines lose about 50 yards. A lot of the players wearing tape, picking up knocks in group games. Thursday, Sunday schedule for this tournament. Chinese Taipei only played two group games. You'd expect them to be the fresher of the two. Bit of a mystery why they haven't turned up so far, but give credit to the Philippines because they have played well and have tried to get on the front foot. And Taipei have struggle to get going. The ball is not clear. Bolden with the back header. And flicked in! A goal straight after half time from Quezada. And the Philippines take the lead. It's what the game needed. And now Chinese Taipei will have to open up. Quinley Quezada. Just sticking a boot out and guiding it past the goalkeeper, just inside the post. And it nestles in the net. And the Philippines are in front. Now, Chinese Taipei really do have to up their game. Great start to the second half. Tenth international goal for Quinley Quezada. Players are a little bit confused about what's going on. I don't think there's a VAR check. I wonder if that's why we are just pausing. No indication that there is one. The referee has yet to restart the game. Certainly didn't seem to be anything wrong with it on first viewing or on the couple of replays we saw. But until the game restarts, we won't know for sure. The Philippines have deserved that goal in their first half performance. An opportunist strike. Quinley Quezada. Doesn't seem to be anything wrong with that. Header in. They're looking for possibly offside. No, the game has restarted, so the goal stands, and the Philippines lead 1-0. And now Chinese Taipei have to come out of their shell and have to be more positive. Philippines have never been to a World Cup. It would be hugely significant for their football culture. Long covering. Daniel puts a foot through it. Somebody came back from an offside position. Do Chinese Taipei have a goal or two in them? Certainly on the evidence of the first half showing, you'd have to question that. But they can raise their game, and now they need to. Lai. They have a corner. Harrison backtracking, concedes the corner, Xu will take it. Chinese Taipei looking to strike back right away. A lecture from the referee first, about pushing and shoving in the area. Now Xu is ready and the referee's ready. It's a good header, and there was a foot in there again. Ah, oh, the flag has gone up. And it was a Philippines player that stuck a foot out. That could have gone anywhere. Yes, it was. It was Harrison. But the offside flag was up, and the Philippines goal remains intact. frustration started to creep into Chinese Taipei. Bolden is beaten to it. Long covering. Su chases. Madurang can't prevent the throw-in. And Chinese Taipei playing with a bit more urgency now. Wong poking it forward. Fancy Su may have been offside. Here she is again. Madurang sticking a boot out. The ball has gone out of play. Good turn. Randall away, important header, miss kick from Bolden. Oh, but she's got that one right. Daniel almost on the end of it. Chinese Taipei have it back. Randall away, but straight to her blue shirt. Wong falls over, referee says play on. Gilu calms things down and goes back to her goalkeeper. And McDaniel clears. Up to Bolden. And they've lost the ball. And this is Xu. Lee's in the middle. And Chinese Taipei are starting to put a bit of pressure on the Philippines. It's what we wanted to see. It's what we know they're capable of. And it's taken a goal down. Going a goal down for them to just raise the tempo a little bit. So difficult moments for Philippines as they try to contain this Chinese Taipei side who are hurting from conceding a goal. Bolden will chase. Nearly got there first. Desperate defending from Lai. She's proved to be a handful tonight. And Serena Bolden. Harrison will wind one up. Chinese Taipei have to be on their guard. Back to Harrison. First time cross. Bolden sweeps it goalwards. Pan comes away with it for Chinese Taipei. Chen under pressure from Madurang. And that's good play from the right wing back, who now has to turn away. Randall takes no chances. Really good play from the goal scorer, Quezada. Bringing the ball down, saying let's play, let's put it on the deck and play. Perhaps Randall has other ideas. She is a defender and there could be problems here. Randall has the pace. She's done well. No doubt that Chinese Taipei now carry much more of a goal threat as Gilu commits the foul. Joe did well to protect the ball there. And Lee has got behind them. Universal football shout of away echoes round this empty stadium. Joe. Chasing is McDaniel. Joe. Over the head of Su. McDaniel falls on the ball. Eats up a little bit more time. Perhaps now it's the Philippines who are conscious of the clock. just going to take a little bit more time than they did in the first half. Loose clearance. Quezada keeps hold of it, does well again. Very tidy on the ball. Harrison's pass down the line is intercepted. Throw in Philippines. Bolden charges down the attempted clearance. Play goes on. Harrison seemed to be hurt. Sue chasing. McDaniel keeps her eye on it and pumps it out of play. We've seen much more of Dominique Randall in this second half because Chinese Taipei have upped the pace. Under pressure by the hard running Sue. Joe will just wait. Campbell says that's mine. Daniel in no hurry. Chinese Taipei back off. Daniel pings it all the way through for a goal kick at the other end. Concentration. The Philippines goalkeeper. So it just feels like the Philippines have weathered that post-goal storm that Chinese Taipei tried to whip up. One-nil, this game is far from over. Free kick to Chinese Taipei. Keeper comes and judged it well. Wants to get them going quickly this time. Quezada the target. Really good take. Excellent take. Is that because she came back from an offside position, or was there a little bit of hands in that? Fantastic control. I don't think it was hands. Chinese Taipei backtracking and getting it clear. Sue will chase. Long is covering. As effective in this second half, but then they haven't had as much of the ball. Philippines, they are closing in on a first ever place at the World Cup finals. Chinese Taipei. Okay. Battling away for it in midfield. In goes Shu. Dugai in the holding midfield role finds Harrison. Harrison looking for McDaniel. That's a loose touch, and McDaniel does have it. Oh, that's 35 yards out with three or four players who you could pass to. Bolden wins the header, and McDaniel is in now. And this time she crosses. Hard running from Gillu, but she couldn't get there. Good anticipation, taking the gamble, getting possession. Wong miss kicks. Dugai collects. Long for Philippines. Flicked on by Bolden. Goalkeeper's ball. She wants everybody out. Dugai takes charge. Philippines have lost it in midfield. Lee, perhaps not realising that she didn't have much space to work with. Concedes a throw-in. Philippines making progress down their left-hand side. As you go, Kazua has to come up with a solution, and quickly. Oh, McDaniel can charge this down, and she does. Working hard. Perhaps not always taking the right options, but no questioning her work ethic. Long wins the header. Chinese Taipei can come again. This is Chen. Long covering. Winning the physical battle. First time forward. Dugai loses out. Wong again. Industrious in midfield. And once more. Lee involved. Miklat giving the ball away. McDaniel doing well to hold it up under pressure. Quezada, she's very tidy on the ball. Hardly ever gives it away, or hardly ever seems to give it away. Combining with Miklat. In steps Harrison. Shu takes over. Really well read by Harrison. Firm header away. Chinese Taipei putting the pressure on. Randall this time. Harrison just about gets there. It's a little bit scrappy, and I wonder if that will suit Philippines. As Bolden calms things down a little bit. Plays a really nice ball and gets Madarang in, and they're on the move here. shot straight at the goalkeeper. Again, very ambitious from that distance from Quezada. Giving it straight back. So giving Philippines an opportunity to get into their defensive shape. Both sides using the long ball. Turning is Madarang. Picked up by Pan. Now Chen. Chen with a bit of pace, but overruns the ball. And a change. Chinese Taipei. Lee off. Tong on. She has a goal in her. Tong Chi brought on to bolster the front line. Harrison. Asking Gilu to run. Gilu forced backwards. Daniel forward. Shoot. Battling away. Illegally, says the referee. Free kick, Philippines. Shoot can't believe it. Philippines respond with a substitution of their own. Quezada, the goal scorer, is going off. If there was a crowd, they'd rise to her. This was her moment. Flicking home, the only goal of the game so far. Anis is on. Not just the goal by Quezada, she's been very tidy in possession. Where did that go? Tong didn't know, that was a little bit lucky. Ball hit against her, and she felt that. Unlikely to get too much sympathy from the Philippines goalkeeper. It's just a hint of an error there. Could have gone anywhere. So a lot of movement on the Philippines bench, and perhaps that's the reason why Quezada came off, heavily strapped thigh. Physio on for Tong, who has only just come on. And now has to go off, but she looks like she's going to be okay. Back stretched. That didn't work. ready to go. Just a shade over 15 minutes for the Philippines to hold out and to claim a first ever place at a World Cup final and set up a semi-final with Korea Republic on Thursday. The Women's Asian Cup, it's a great story. But is there another chapter to be written? Bolden. McDaniel, a willing runner again. Gilu was making good ground. Will be happy for Miklat to take her time on this set piece. Another goal now would all but kill the game. Bolden, one of those underneath it, along with Long. Who got the final touch? It might have been Bolden, actually. No matter, it's over the crossbar. Wasted by the goalkeeper. Every moment precious for Chinese Taipei as they seek a way back into this game. Bolden flicks it on. McDaniel picks it up, does really well. Annis, and there is Bolden with the header. Coming more into the game, Serena Bolden, after a quietish second half. Substitute Annis with the cross, and perhaps Bolden just got her geography slightly wrong. Gilu can't prevent the ball going out for a throw-in. Boot in the face, free kick. Tinchi, the offender. Annis, looking for Bolden. She's got into the game. It's Tanai Annis. Studies at the University of Florida in the United States. So many of the squad at college in America. Throw of the dice for Chinese Taipei.
Substitution for Chinese Taipei. And number four, Lin Weiyu, replaced by pair number 13, Han Yanxin.
Defender for a defender. Han is on. Handler's largely had the measure of her, but here she is again. Chance here, Wong. Oh. probably their best opportunity of the second half. Good play from Sue. Ting helped it on. And Wong off balance, sends it wide. The clock is ticking for Chinese Taipei. Miscontrol from Chen. We are approaching the last 10 minutes in Pune. Earlier on, we saw an absorbing quarterfinal between Australia and Korea Republic, settled by a wonder goal late on. Can't quite put Quezada's goal in that category. It certainly is an important one. But we will only know at the final whistle how important it's going to be. Daniel didn't win the header, but the ball almost fell for Anis. Chinese Taipei keep it in and clear it long. Time for Harrison. Bolden still working hard. The front two have been really good for the Philippines. Harrison doesn't have to chase too hard. The ball goes out of play and McDaniel says no thank you to the spare ball. I'll go and get that one in my own time. We are into the last 10 minutes. Chinese Taipei throw. And now they have a free kick. Joe! My word! What a goal! 8 minutes to play, and out of nowhere, Chinese Taipei have found an equaliser. The coach claps, the players celebrate. An extraordinary strike. And Joe has equalised. Nothing McDaniel could do about that. Seemed to be no danger on the left foot. Oh! What a goal! And we're all tied up at 1-1. ...83 on the clock. Got a yellow card. She'd probably think that's a fair trade-off. 1-1. And now extra time may well come into play. Bolden challenging. Picks up the loose ball. Wins a corner. Philippines have to lift themselves up, not let their heads drop. They were close. But this is the game of football. Until the final whistle goes, you never know. Anis wins the header. Bolden trying to get it in with any part of the body. I think it came off her back. Let's have a look. Off her shoulder. That could well have crept in. Bolden does well again, earns a corner. Chinese Taipei have to concentrate here. Gilu is short. Miklat waits. Miklat takes. Goalkeeper stays at home. Good defensive header away. Randall pumps it back in. It's a clean header. Oh, that was a chance. That was a really good chance for Bugai. Chen can't control the attempted quick counter-attacking ball from the goalkeeper. Stadić, the Philippines coach, oh so close. A little bit of tiredness from McDaniel. She has it, or she had it back. Free kick goes the way of Chinese Taipei. Substitute Pan standing her ground. Goalkeeper's ball. Wong in midfield. Cleared away. Two minutes to go. Daniel pokes it forward. Tidying up is Joe, the scorer of a wonder goal. Extra time beckons. Chinese Taipei have another throw in. Harrison backtracking. Here's Ting. Beats one, pokes it past the second. The rebound falls kindly for the Philippines. And the hard running McDaniel forces Pan to put it out for a throw in. Free kick, Chinese Taipei. Players feeling the pace. Been a really good second half. First half was a little bit low on energy and a little bit disappointing, even though the Philippines played the better of the two. Second half, especially with that early goal, has been much, much better. And graced by a special strike from Joe in the 83rd minute. McDaniel heads it on. Wong. That was a foul, so 4 minutes of stoppage time. And there's a set piece opportunity for Chinese Taipei. Su has worked so hard as the lone front runner. Xu and Wong in conversation. Referee makes sure the wall is the right distance away from the ball. What have Chinese Taipei got up their sleeves? Su Ting and Chung wait. And then it does come in. Up in the air. Philippines need to get it away, and then it's harmlessly over the crossbar from Ping Chi. Bolden first to it. Clever, nice touch as well from Gilu. Asking a bit too much of McDaniel and Bolden, but they win a throw in. Harrison with it. Back to Harrison. She measures the cross, glanced away. Retrieved by Madarang. Forward from Long. And flicked on. McDaniel is in there. Pan prevents another corner. Late pressure from the Philippines. Get hold of it. Another throw. Madarang might go long with this one. McDaniel turns. Another throw in. Into the last minute. Flicked on at the near post. Ball didn't go out. Still in the penalty area. Anis. Anis does well. Driving for the byline, dropped by the goalkeeper. Corner nervy moment for Chinese Taipei and their goalkeeper, Chong, who dropped the ball. The referee's whistle goes. Is that for a substitution, I wonder? Or are they having a look on VAR? Play can continue. Goalkeeper has dropped it again. Oh, panic in the Chinese Taipei defence, but they get it clear. Back it comes. Miklat will pick up the loose ball. Bolden with the header. Goalkeeper grabs it. And that is the end of regulation time. It's extra time we go. 15 minutes each way. 1-1 the score after 90 minutes. Both goals coming in the second half. Quezada putting the Philippines ahead, poking home from close range on 49. And then a fantastic strike from Joe on 83, making it 1-1. That was the first goal of the game. Chinese Taipei came close pretty soon afterwards. They had a much better second half, did Chinese Taipei. It looked innocuous, and Joe on her left foot. Unbelievable strike. Absolute perfection. Right at the death. Coming off the shoulder of Bolden. And it finished 1-1 after 90 minutes. Coaches taking the opportunity to have a team talk in this short break before we start extra time. And whatever the Chinese Taipei coach said at halftime to his team, it certainly worked. Philippines, they grafted for the whole 90 minutes. It was difficult to see where Chinese Taipei were going to get a goal from. And that's the kind of thing that can happen. And all credit to Joe for having a go from distance. It's going to be a very grueling half hour for these players. The leaders on the Philippines team, amongst the playing staff, G'ing their teammates up. There's the two skippers. Attend the coin toss. And Long wins it for the Philippines. The Philippines have 5. Substitutes left. Certainly can use an extra one in extra time. Chinese Taipei have used 2 substitutes. And we are getting set, getting ready to go again in Pune. Still Chinese Taipei are in a huddle. And they too are now good to go. Now it does come down to fitness. Fitness and conditioning. Who has the fittest team? Alan Stadich or his opposite number? Shigo Katsua. Chinese Taipei, get us underway for this first period of extra time. Tani Anis, who made an impact after coming on as a substitute. She's got an opportunity to make even more of an impact as Joe, the goal scorer, goes down the line with the throw-in. Miklat, misplaced. The Philippines were less than 7 minutes away from their first ever World Cup finals and the semi-finals of the Women's Asian Cup, and denied by a great goal. Now they have to go again. Perhaps the momentum is with Chinese Taipei. Anis was chasing. Covering was S.Y. Su. Chung Lee, Chinese Taipei goalkeeper, had a little bit to do at the end of the game when it got a bit frantic. It was mostly quiet after that early goal in the second half. Anis. Bolden. I'm not surprised she looks a little bit leggy, a little bit tired. She has worked so hard, especially in the first half. She caused the Chinese Taipei defence all sorts of problems. Chen wins another throw-in. Madurang. Chen takes over. Run of the ball just going Chinese Taipei's way at the moment. Chen takes it quickly. To another player who has worked so hard. Earlier on today, Korea Republic beat Australia with another great goal, another late great goal. They are waiting for the winners of this one in Pune on Thursday. I think they'll probably be thinking, well, tell you what, you lot can play extra time. We've got our feet up. Bugai maintains possession. Niklat has to have been pretty effective in those holding midfield positions. Chen turns into trouble. Bolden will chase. Tan with the flick. Anis can't get there. Everything coming off for Chinese Taipei at the moment. Su running. Randall, little mistake from here. Her. Oh, and she recovers brilliantly. And they prevent a corner. That's the first sign of weakness from Randall at the back. And then Madurang draws the foul. Dominique Randall, just a heavy touch. Look at that for a covering tackle. Good athlete. Bolden the target. McDaniel can't get there. The shot is straight into the arms of the goalkeeper from Anis. Was from the right place, but the referee's trotting back just to make sure Chung is okay. She needs some attention from the physio. It's a pretty solid game at the back, along with Lai and Su. Couple of moments of alarm, including the, of course, the goal. Otherwise, they've dealt pretty effectively with what Philippines threw at them. China struggling. Howard Stadich. Shigo Ketsua, still locked in combat. Chung will try and run it off. It's been a pretty scrappy opening 7.5 minutes. Of extra time. Ball stays in play. Long is covering. Olivia McDaniel has it and will pick it up. Taipei back off. Anis is beaten in the air. Bugai. Oh, and the ball does get through to Gilu. Madurang loses out. Tingchi. Forward from Shu. Long had to step in. over the head of Randall. Goalkeeper comes. Good work from Gilou, nipping in to nick it away. Bolden will keep this one in. Insider is Madarang, who just lost bearings for a second. Long. Strong in the challenge. Nice layoff. Annis goes for the first time ball. Trying to knock it down for Bolden, who gets there. And Bolden goes for goal. Philippine substitute. Carly Freelis. Daniel has run herself into the ground, so some fresh legs up front for Philippines in the shape of Carly Frillis. Wong, Chen, Randall, another heavy touch. Oh, and Chinese Taipei may prosper here. They're asking for a penalty. And a VAR review. Sue claims she was fouled. Chen steps away. Appears there is a conversation going on. Meanwhile, another substitution will take place. A double one. Lin, number three, is a forward who's coming on to replace Sue. She's had a good game. So on, and it's the midfielder Chen. Oh, that was an important header. It's Chen, the substitute. Leaves it to Pan. Players are tired, mistakes are happening. And this is a good spell in the game for Chinese Taipei. Daniel shouts and comes and gathers and collects and releases it quickly. Bolden's underneath it. Couldn't find Gilou, who has moved into a more central position. Madarang does well. Here is Gilou and Bolden. Freelis nearly fell to Gilou. Clash. It's going to be a free kick to Chinese Taipei. Players really feeling the pace now. Flag went up for a foul. Serena Bolden. Chinese Taipei have the throw. Another free kick. Just breaking up the rhythm of the game. Substitutions, free kicks, injury stoppages. Last minute of the first half of extra time. 1-1 after 90 minutes. It's a tired free kick as well. Who's got the energy? Bolden. Oh, really good ball. And they could be in here. They could be in here. Oh, so close. Really good effort. Gilu went round the goalkeeper from the tightest of angles, almost found the back of the net. Oh, she's off. Would have been a great finish. One minute of stoppage time. Played 30 seconds of it. Forward from Anis, who's now on the left-hand side for Philippines. Chen. Half-time in extra time. Players will take a very brief pause. It's like a water break before they start the second period of extra time. Both goals coming in the second half of normal time. Four minutes after the restart. Quesada poking home from close range, squeezing it between the goalkeeper and post. And then on 83, Joe with a wonder goal with the equaliser. Quick team huddle from Chinese Taipei. Showed a lot of spirit. Kept going. Even when things weren't running their way, they upped their game in the second half. Found an extra gear and it paid off late on in normal time. To stay in the game, stay in the tournament and stay in the hunt for a World Cup place. Neither side has ever participated in a FIFA World Cup. And that's going to change this evening. First though, the second half of extra time. Bugai turns away, finds Long. Anis. Heavy touch, trying to take it on. Bolden. Bugai. Miklat. Lost control just for a second. Harrison. Good ball. Oh, It's gone out of play. Oh, maybe it didn't cross the line. Frillis. Throw in. It now has crossed the line, that's for sure. Gilu trying to find some room for the cross. Goal kick. If it stays like this, it will go to penalties. Only one of the quarterfinals to go to extra time. Gilu trying to take it first time. She was outnumbered. Long puts her head in, wins the ball. Harrison. And again. Asking a lot of Gilu. She did well to get there. And Philippines have it back. Frillis. Too strong for Bolden. Right weight on the pass, and it would have been interesting. Harrison's done well. That's tired from Miklat, giving the ball away. Chen can't collect. Randall clears. Up to Gilu, still full of running. To play from Sue. Some very tired players out there. Bolden grafting away. Wins a throw in. Harrison. Miklat. Harrison does well. And again. Opportunity here for Frillis to cross. Tries to go inside. Goalkeeper judges it well. She was under pressure. The clearance is a long one. Ting is chasing all the way through to the goalkeeper. Harrison, the recipient of the throw. A bit of an aimless pass. Randall chasing. Oh, who did that come off last? Goal kick has been given. Castaneda. It's going to come on.
Substitution for Philippines. Player number 25, Katrina Kuro. Replaced by player number 25, Sarah.
The older sister of Annika, who's also in the squad. Two pairs of sisters. Lydia McDaniel, the older sister of Chandler McDaniel. Harrison, good energy from her. Chinese Taipei do really well to play out of the press. And Chen takes it on. Harmlessly behind for a goal kick. Would have been some team goal, that one. Lin from a tight angle. It's been scrappy in extra time. Tiredness is winning at the moment. Can somebody come up with another moment of magic? A burst of energy to settle this game before we go to penalties. Less than 8 minutes to go in this second period of extra time. Long back to her goalkeeper. Wong. Her distribution has been really good in midfield. Zhou, scorer of Chinese Taipei's goal. Pan's cross is intercepted. Think a free kick. Or is she giving one away? Yes, it is a Chinese Taipei free kick. 3 to Amat on the edge of the area. For Su. Xu will retrieve it. Lin. Against Madarang. Chen. Cross is blocked. No corner is the cry. Randall does prevent it from going out. Anis can bring it away. She belts it away. It's Chinese Taipei who are coming on strong in the last minutes of extra time. Throw in Chinese Taipei. I don't think saw that challenge. It was quite a strong one. Still there for Chinese Taipei. Good play from Randall. Maybe the offside flag had gone up eventually. Against Chen. Into the last 5 minutes. Philippines have two substitutions left. I wonder if Alan Stedic is thinking who is a good penalty taker that I have on the bench still. Bolden. He's looking for Castaneda. Play on. A bit of hesitation in the Philippines defence. Castaneda's touch is a heavy one. Joe, and still battling away. Really good play from her. She gets past Harrison as well. Fantastic play from Joe. Given everything. Gets past one. Gets past two. Gets past another one. And then another one. Less than 3 minutes from penalties. Castaneda turns into trouble. Randall lets it go over her head. The goalkeeper let her know that it was okay for her to do that. McDaniel is poised to play a central part in the next phase of this quarterfinal. Free kick, Philippines. It's fouled by Shu. It has been a hard-fought game. Nip and tuck all the way. Harrison turning away from trouble. Long can't control it. Joe again. Ting. Randall comes across. One or two moments of alarm from Dominique Randall, but overall, really solid game. Reads it well. Strong in the challenge. Good in the air. Go for a throw-in into the last minute of extra time. Don't think either. Oh, it's a corner. It's a corner for Chinese Taipei. And Olivia McDaniel has ended up on the deck. Shoot to swing it over. Possibly the last opportunity of this game. That was a very tired corner, and we are now in stoppage time at the end of extra time. 1-1. Don't think either goalkeeper has had to make a save in extra time. And that is the final whistle. 120 minutes of football. Couldn't separate these sides. Thanks to that fantastic goal from Joe. 7 minutes from the end of normal time. So now it's about spot kicks. It's about goalkeepers. It's about holding your nerve. A place in the semi-finals a place in the World Cup finals is at stake. Confirmation of the full time and extra time score, 1-1. So there may well be some formalities to sort out which end they're going to take the penalties from, who's going to go first. Best of five. Third coin toss of the match so far. Looks like Wong has won it. What do you want to do? Yet another team huddle for Chinese Taipei. Chung Seo Yu, the goalkeeper for Chinese Taipei. Olivia McDaniel, the goalkeeper for the Philippines. Best of five. And if they're still level, sudden death. Neither goalkeeper had an awful lot to do during the game, but they are now the focus of attention. There she goes. Katsua looks nervous. So Chinese Taipei, first to go. Ting Chi came on as a substitute in the second half. She faces Olivia McDaniel. long as McDaniel stays on her line, she can bounce up and down, she can clap, she can wave her arms. The first penalty of this shootout is a good one. Right into the side of the net. Sara Castaneda, the first to go for Philippines. Chung Sir Yu is the goalkeeper. Castaneda puts it in the top corner. 1-1. That's what it feels like after you've scored. Good pen. Chinese Taipei captain Wong, next to go. Wong for Chinese Taipei. Goalkeeper goes the wrong way. 2 out of 2 for Chinese Taipei. They lead 2-1. Tony Annis, another one of the second half substitutes, the second penalty taker for the Philippines. Annis, two steps and fires it into the net. 4 really good penalties so far, 2 all in the shootout. On we go, faultless so far. Chen with penalty number 3 for Chinese Taipei. Another substitute. McDaniel waits. Another very well struck kick from the spot. Chinese Taipei have scored all 3 of their penalties. And next up for Philippines. It's Miklat. Oh, it's saved! First blood to Chinese Taipei. Miklat has had her penalty saved. And Chinese Taipei lead 3-2, and both sides have had 3 penalties each. The pressure now on Olivia McDaniel. Important moment in the shootout. It would put so much pressure on the next Philippines player to step up. Here's Xu. Hands on hips. Oh, and she's missed! And 1 miss each. Chinese Taipei lead 3-2. Up steps the skipper. Hayley Long. The captain for the Philippines. Oh, it's saved! It is saved! Wasn't a good penalty. It almost crept in the top corner. And now, Sue can win it for Chinese Taipei. This for a place in the semi-finals of the Women's Asia Cup. And looking a little bit further ahead, a place for the first time ever in the World Cup finals. And Sue nonchalantly walks across to gather the ball. McDaniel waits. If she scores, there's no coming back for the Philippines. Some can hardly bear to look. Sue for Chinese Taipei against McDaniel. Oh, McDaniel saves it. What a poor penalty that was. And the Philippines live to breathe another day. They still lead 3-2 though. So the Philippines have to score this penalty. Otherwise, they are out. Oh, and the goalkeeper taking responsibility. Stepping up to the plate. She has to score. Both sides have missed two penalties. But the Philippines have one left. And their goalkeeper, Olivia McDaniel, has opted to take it. Opted to take the responsibility. And she scores! Cool as a cucumber. 3-3. And we're into sudden death. Bit more comfortable, I would fancy, between the sticks. Now, Joe, who scored that fantastic equaliser, had a really good game. Penalty number 6 for Chinese Taipei. McDaniel waits and saves! It's another poor penalty, and suddenly it's the Philippines in the box seat. Third miss in a row for Chinese Taipei, too close to the goalkeeper. And now, Serena Bolden can send the Philippines to Australia and New Zealand next year and into a semi-final matchup with the Korea Republic. It's Bolden for the Philippines. And Bolden has done it! The Philippines are through to the Final Four. They're through to the World Cup Finals. What drama! 1-1. After normal time, no goals in extra time, the penalty shootout went to sudden death, and Serena Bolden has sent the Philippines into ecstasy. What a moment for the team, for the country, and for their football culture. Chinese Taipei are out on their knees. The Philippines celebrate. The coach is emotional. The country must be going wild. But spare a thought for Chinese Taipei. They are out of the competition, having scored a late, late equaliser. But the celebrations belong to the Philippines. It's them that move into the semi-finals. They will play Korea on Thursday. And they will be in Australia and New Zealand for the World Cup in 2023.